Hello everyone, this is Professor Govind. In this video, let us understand what gateway is in computer networks. We'll understand the advantages of internet and also we'll talk about cyber crimes and cyber laws. Let us first start with the technical term called gateway. Gateway in computer networks is a technique of connecting two or more networks together. Connecting two or more computers is called a computer network, and connecting two or more such networks is with gateway or by using gateway. So understand the difference between computer network and a gateway. Computer network is a connection of more computers, two or more computers, whereas gateway is a connection of two or more networks. By using gateway, two or more networks can be connected, and by connecting two or more networks, we can form a larger network, for example, internet. So gateway is a special purpose dedicated computer that is attached to two or more networks. It sends packets. By packet, we mean here information. When you send information, information is divided. When you transfer information in a computer network, information generally is divided in smaller sections. For example, 10 MB of information, if you want to transfer, it will be divided in 1 MB of information each. So such small sections of information are called frames, are called packets, are called data bits. So packet is nothing but an information. It sends packets from one computer network to other network. It is a hardware. It can be a hardware or a software. Gateway is available in both the forms, in a hardware form as well as in a software or application form. It is a hardware or a software which allows different networks to communicate with each other using TCP/IP. It is a device that links two networks, two or more networks together and translates data between different networks. So this is the way by which two networks can be connected to each other. This is the way by which two networks communicate with each other. Two networks is two groups of computers can communicate with each other, can share data. So gateway is a bridge. Gateway is a connecting bridge of two networks. It is available in both the forms, that is in hardware as well as software format or software form. A search engine, as we all know, is a site wherein we can search for information, when we can navigate information on the internet. Technically, it is a software program or a script or a code available through the internet that searches documents and files for keywords and returns the results of any files containing those keywords. Today, there are thousands of different search engines available on the internet, each with their own abilities, features, and characteristics. The first search engine ever developed is considered Aachi, which was used to search for FTP, that is files, and first text-based search engine is considered Veronica. And as we all know, the most popular search engine we have on this date is Google. So all the search engines work on the keyword that you enter. If I want to search information about GCC, I can use various keywords like Gokte College, Commerce Colleges in Belgium, Commerce Colleges in Tilakwadi, etc. So your search result depends on what keyword you have used. Better the keyword, more accurate the result will be. So what search engines do is, based on your keyword, they search the table, they search the information, and in whatever website, in whichever website the entered keyword is available, those websites will be listed in your search list. All the search engines work on the same principle. Let us now talk about the advantages of internet. There are various advantages of using internet. There are many uses or features of internet. We have listed only few which are quite common, which are quite popular. So internet, because it is a global connection of computers, it can have global users. Anything which is displayed on internet is available across the world to all the users. So it is not restricted geographically to a particular region, to a particular area, etc. If it is connected with internet, then it has global users. Internet is available 24/7. There are no time restrictions. And as compared to other communication mediums or other mediums, it is quite inexpensive. We don't spend much money on connecting our system to internet, or we don't spend much money on using internet. So it is relatively inexpensive. Not free though, but is inexpensive as compared to other mediums of communication. Let us now have a look at applications of internet. There again, we have lot many applications. But we have restricted our list to the ones which are quite popular or to the ones which are connected with our feet. Primarily, internet is used for communication. The internet has been mankind's greatest means of communication yet. Newer innovations are only making it faster and more reliable as well as efficient. Today, we can initiate real-time communication with someone who is in another part of the world. So communication is the primary use of internet. We can communicate with any number of people. It can be one-to-one, it can be one-to-many, it can be many-to-many. We can communicate with many people and let those people be at any corner of the world. We can communicate in real time. Real time is within a second we can pass our message to them. There are many platforms available for communication with the help of internet. So it is the primary use of the application of internet. Internet also is used for finding, for accessing information resources. The internet is a treasure of information which offers knowledge on any given topic. Search engines make information accessible on various subjects such as government laws, services, trade fairs, conferences, market information, new innovations, technical support, or any other pattern or the kind of information is available within seconds with the help of internet. So internet is also used for accessing, for navigating through websites which have information resources. Internet, I must say, one of the popular service of the internet is e-commerce. Internet is also used for selling or purchasing goods or services on the global platform with the help of internet, wherein it has various advantages, like it will be more interactive. You can advertise your products or services in more efficient way. So there are various advantages of having e-commerce or online services. There again, we can have global consumers or global customers. We can have 24/7 open store, and it can be interactive. Presentation will be more better as compared to other advertisement means, etc. So internet is also used in the field or in the section of e-commerce or online services, other online services. Quite a popular service nowadays on the internet. And then we have education as well, where e-books are available, online tutors are available. We can connect with our teacher using internet. So internet is also used in the field of education. We can download the books, we can download the information, we can access the classes, we have e-tutors. There are various sources available through which we can access various information, various source of information. Then we have is entertainment. Internet is also used for, or in the field of entertainment, for playing games, for downloading music, for playing videos, for downloading videos, etc. One of the most important part of internet is security. As internet is an open system, anybody can connect to internet, anybody can access information which is available in an open mode. Hence, we'll have to think about how the data is protected or how the security is provided. for the information which is available on the internet. As internet is an open system, systems connected or the computers connected to the internet are subjected to harmful programs and hackers. Your programs, your data can be hacked, your data can be destroyed by unauthorized users. Hence, proper controlling techniques are needed to secure or to protect internet so that security is maintained. So when you talk about the services provided on internet, by internet, the primary concern is the security provided. We'll have to think twice about providing security to the data which is available on internet. Internet security involves browser security, network security, application security, and system security. So we can protect our data on the internet at various levels, at browser level, at network level, at application level, that is at website level, for example, or system security, which is the most efficient security mechanism available. Browser security is available at the client side, the least amount of security that can be provided. Network security is provided by certain softwares like firewall, like antivirus softwares, etc. Application security is provided by the designer of the website, by the owner of the website, so that the clients which are available on that particular website, they do not lose their data. Any unauthorized access should not happen on a particular website. That will be application security. That is called application security. And then we have is system security. Techniques for ensuring security. We can install firewalls. As I said, firewall is a special hardware or a software. This firewall again is available both in hardware and in software form, which prevents unauthorized access to the computer. Firewall is one of the most powerful technique or a technology which is used to prevent your computer and your data as well from unauthorized access. It asks for a permission from the owner every time the unauthorized access comes to your particular website or a computer. It prevents any unauthorized access to your computer or to your website. Using antivirus softwares used to detect and remove viruses, trojans, malwares, etc. Using cryptography, most commonly used technique to avoid unauthorized access. Cryptography is a technique of changing our data pattern or data format. Cryptography provides secure communication, secured or protected communication in the presence of from the unauthorized access. Encryption uses a certain kind of algorithm. Cryptography uses a technique called encryption. And what encryption is nothing but an algorithm which changes the pattern of your data. If you send data as ABC, for example, it will be changed as 123 or XYZ, etc. So it changes the pattern of your data. And the original data, it makes sure that the original data reaches only the destination, only the receiver. Whatever data sender sends, it makes sure cryptography makes sure that the data sent by the sender reaches only the destination or the receiver. Any unauthorized access will result in displaying some other pattern of data. If I try to hack the data, which is encrypted by cryptography, then I never will receive the original data. I'll receive some other pattern of data. So cryptography or encryption is all about changing the pattern of data so that original data will never be visible to unauthorized users. Original data will be opened, will be accessed only and only by the original receiver or the destination. So it is one of the most commonly used technique on the internet. Applying filtering of websites which restricts unauthorized access or unwanted sites will be restricted by applying filters at browser security using web browsers. We can restrict unauthorized access or say we can restrict our users from opening unwanted websites by setting this filter at the web browser level. by using the web browser. The last topic of this module or this unit, cybercrime. The crime committed in relation to a computer or a computer network is called cybercrime. For example, unauthorized access of data, hacking, destroying others' data, etc. Nature of cybercrimes, blocking or damaging computer data through viruses, malwares, etc. Unauthorized access, modification, customization of others' data. Adding offensive comments also is a part of cybercrime on especially these social platforms. Illegal online gambling. Some of the websites about gambling are legal, but it is all about illegal online gambling and selling of illegal articles comes under cybercrime. Frauds in credit card operating or other online financial services. Fraud in any kind of financial service is considered as a cybercrime. And for these crimes, we have a punishment mentioned in cyber laws. Cyber laws are the legal directives or regulations implemented and amended by government body to provide legal recognition to electronic documents. It also provides a framework to control cyber crimes. Cyber law is essential as it covers all types of transactions and activities happening on the internet. So cyber law, which was designed in October 2000 in India, prevents users, internet users, from all kinds of cyber crimes. It provides legal recognition for all e-commerce transactions or all e-transactions. It gives legal recognition to digital signatures as a valid signature to accept agreements, apart from preventing data. So this is about cyber law. The main purpose of the act is to provide legal recognition to electronic commerce or e-transactions, all the kinds of e-transactions, and to facilitate filing of electronic records with the government. Cyber laws also facilitate e-filing and other facilities, along with preventing all the internet users from cyber crimes. So this is the end of this unit of internet, and these are the topics we have with internet. Thank you, everyone.